Hello friends, welcome to one more video. This video is on the topic of demand analysis. Friends, watch this video so that your concept will get clear and you will able to get more marks. Watch this video till end. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and don't forget to like. Let us see the question in detail. What do you understand by demand? Demand means a desire of a commodity. The commodity can be goods and services. Now, only desire does not mean demand. It should have ability to pay also and willingness to buy. So when three things combines, that is a desire of a commodity plus ability and willingness, then it amounts to demand. Then it can be said that it is demand. Now going forward, what do you mean by examples of ability to pay? A beggar desires to travel by air is not demand because he has only desire but not ability to pay for air ticket. So he does not have the ability to pay. Therefore, you should have a ability to pay. However, a rich man desire to travel by air can be considered as demand because he is able to pay for that air ticket. Okay, now let us see the example of willingness to buy. What is the example of willingness to buy? If a rich man desires to travel by air, but if he is not willingness to pay for the ticket, then even his desire will not give rise to demand. It means you should be willing to buy a particular commodity. Then it will amount to demand. Let us see in detail demand schedule. Demand schedule is the table showing graphical presentation of a particular commodity at a particular price. I have given price 4321 and quantity demanded is 10, 20, 30, 40. Now this is a demand schedule of Mr. X for a particular period of time. Now you don't have to remember this, you can write any figure, but whatever you write you need to explain in the diagram. Going forward, what is law of demand? When other factors influencing demand remains unchanged, if price of goods fall, its demand expands, and if price of goods rise, its demand contracts. Therefore, we can say that there is an inverse relationship between price and demand. Let us draw a diagram which will make it very much clear to you. Friends, just see the way, the method I am drawing the diagram and how to present it without remembering. This is then point of origin O and quantity is shown on x-axis, whereas on y-axis I will denote the price. What I termed this as outer layer of demand curve. Now let us write down 2-3 lines for the same. In the above diagram, quantity demanded is shown on x-axis and price is shown on y-axis. Now, what is this? It's a demand curve and I'll give a name DD. Let us write down something about it also. DD is the demand curve which is a graphical presentation of demand schedule sloping downward from left to right. Now, I am taking a particular point A. At that point, the price is 10 and quantity is also 10. Now, let us write something about it. When price is rupees 10, at this demand is 10 from point A. Now next point will be 5 and 10. When the price will decrease from 10 to 5, the demand will increase from 10 to 15 at point B. Let us write that thing down. Now suppose when price from rupees 10 to 5, the demand is increased from 10 to 15. I am drawing an arrow which will make it more clear. The price decrease from 10 to 5, the demand increase from 10 to 15. Number 5, vice versa. The quantity has shrunk from 15 to 10. When will this happen? When the price will increase from 5 to 10. Therefore, when price decrease, conclusion, therefore, when price increase, demand decrease. And when price decrease, demand increase. This is law of demand. Friends, I'll upload video on every Sunday, so please subscribe to my channel Pranav Classes. Please share if you like it so that friends, brother and sister get more marks. All the best for your exams.